this example, we told the Seymour Micro to watch this PLC tag at DS100 plus 1, so that would be DS101 on this click PLC. If the Seymour Micro sees bit 0 of this tag change from a 0 to a 1, it'll turn tones on. Let's do that. Put a 1 here, and we get tones. If it sees the PLC change bit 0 from a 1 to a 0, it'll turn any tones in progress off. So for example, if we have a tone in progress due to an alarm, and the PLC sets us to a 1, and then changes it back to a 0, it'll kill the alarms. Again, it's the transition from a 1 to a 0 that disables the tone. Simply writing a 0 to this tag when it's already a 0 won't silence the tone, so be careful about that. The Seymour Micro has to see bit 0 change from a 1 to a 0 to silence the tones. The alarms are still in progress, just the tones have been silenced. Note that setting the tones to on by setting this bit to a 1 overrides everything. Likewise, setting it to a 0 from a 1 silences everything that's currently in progress. The alarm condition will still be present, just the tones are silenced. Using this option, the PLC can turn beeps on or even generate patterns of beeps anytime it wants to get the user's attention, signal issues, or anything else you may want it to do. It can also kill tones anytime it wants, again, regardless of what's going on. One more example. If the PLC has this tag set to a 0, and then a new alarm comes in, let me restart this alarm, the alarm will sound. Remember, the Seymour Micro has to see a transition from a 1 to a 0 while the tone is on to disable it. Let's kill that, it's driving me nuts. There we go. So that's beep control via a PLC. You can also use this to modify the behavior of a panel. Normally, the only way a user can silence alarms is by taking care of the alarm condition. Sometimes it's nice to be able to silence the tone while you're working on the alarm so you don't get a headache. The PLC can enable that feature by setting bit 16, which in this case, since we're using an unsigned integer, is a 32768 decimal. Let me put that in there, 32768. That's going to set bit 16. Note that if you're using a 16-bit BCD number, that would be an 8000. So by setting this bit, the PLC is telling the Seymour Micro it's okay to let the user silence the alarm by touching an object on the panel or by touching a function key. Let's try that real quick. So let's see, bit 16 is set. We're going to start an alarm. So now I can silence that alarm by hitting a function key or by hitting an object on the screen. That's a real handy feature to have, and your users will thank you for that. Setting all of this up is easy. Just go to the Navigation Windows Function tab, PLC to Panel, or the Setup menu, PLC to Panel. Go to the PLC to Panel tab, put a tag in here for the Seymour Micro to monitor for this screen number. The Seymour Micro will watch that tag and use it to change screen numbers if that feature is enabled. We don't have it enabled right now. Then the very next tag at that address plus 1, if we enable it, is our beep control word. And by the way, there's a third one at the screen number tag plus 2 that allows the PLC to control the backlight color of the screen. But this video is about beep control, so we're just going to enable that one right now. And that's all there is to it. With this enabled, when the PLC writes to the screen number plus 1, the Seymour Micro will be watching that and will react accordingly. Note that there's a handy reference down here that tells you that at that address, if the PLC writes a 1 to bit 0, it'll turn the beeps on. If it writes a 0, it'll turn the beeps off. And remember, the Seymour Micro has to see a transition from a 1 to a 0 to turn it off, or a 0 to a 1 to turn it on. You simply can't overwrite a 1 or override a 0. Likewise, if the PLC writes to bit 15, he can enable the disabling of beeps by touching the touchscreen or a function key. So that's all there is to controlling beeps from a PLC. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. And as always, please send us any topics you would like to see covered, or any other comments for that matter. We appreciate the feedback.